Oscar Grant, gunned down by cops in Oakland in a vicious murder seen around the world. Adolf Grimes, killed by cops in a hail of 48 bullets as he sat in his car outside his grandmother's home in New Orleans. Robbie Tolan, shot by cops in a suburb of Houston after he protested them roughing up his mother in front of her own home, a shooting that ended his promising baseball career. These outrages occurred within 24 hours of each other on New Year's Day 2009, marking the beginning of another year when police brutalize and even murder people and get away with no punishment. Another year when a whole generation of youth are treated like criminals, guilty until proven innocent, if they can survive their encounters with cops to prove their innocence. Another year when immigration raids split up families and disappear people. Another year when more than 2 million people languish in U.S. prisons. What can you say about a system that does this shit day in and day out to people? If this was the only thing wrong with this setup, this alone would be reason enough to want to get rid of it through revolution. And it is far from the only thing wrong. There's the wars for empire the U.S. is waging in the Middle East. There's the legitimization of torture. There's the way women are treated in this society, looked at as breeders of children or sex objects, not full human beings. There's the countless millions of people who face disease and starvation all over the world. There's the devastation of the environment. A system that inflicts this kind of misery and degradation on people all over the world has been around too damn long and needs to be gotten rid of through revolution. And a new society, a revolutionary society, needs to be built in place of the old one. Now, in this kind of revolutionary society, the new institutions of power would be there to involve people in dealing with the problems that society faces and would back people up in making the necessary changes, not brutalize and suppress them. And those entrusted with public security in this kind of society would sooner take a bullet themselves than kill an innocent person. Now, it's not time yet to make revolution to bring this kind of society into being. The system's not deep enough in trouble yet. And it's going to take a lot of work to get people ready to make this kind of revolution. Work to get more people to see that this system is rotten to the core and needs to be done away with through revolution. And work to bring into being a revolutionary people. Millions of people who are conscious of the need for revolution and determined to fight for it. An important part of this kind, doing this kind of work is organizing people and mobilizing them to stand up and resist outrages like police brutality and police murder, fighting the power and transforming the people for revolution. As the Revolutionary Communist Party says in its statement, the revolution we need and the leadership we have, the days when this system can just do whatever it wants to people here and all over the world, when people are not inspired and organized to stand up and resist and to build up their strength to end this madness once and for all, those days must be gone and can be gone. October 22, 2009 is an important time to stand up against this official brutality and to build the kind of resistance I've been talking about. It's the 14th annual National Day of Protest to Stop Police Brutality, Repression, and the Criminalization of a Generation. On that day, in cities all across the country, people will take to the streets in outrage against police brutality and police murder, against the immigration raids, and against the way the youth are warehoused in prison. There will be rallies and marches on that day, and many, many people will wear black in solidarity with the protests and in memory of those killed by the cops. On October 22nd, we'll be on the streets all day and well into the night. Now, those of us who take to the streets on October 22nd will have different views on how to deal with the problem of police brutality. Some of us will be revolutionaries like me, and others will think differently about what's the problem and what's the solution. There'll also be people from many different backgrounds. There'll be students and youth. There'll be religious leaders, professors, lawyers. Among us will be family members of police murder victims who will have a platform on that day to speak of the devastation that killer cops have inflicted on them and their loved ones. All of us will be out in the streets together on that day delivering a message to the system and its enforcers that we refuse to suffer this brutality in silence. Through our collective resistance, we can inspire many others to stand up and to join in. Now, if you're somebody who thinks that oppressed people need to be subservient when they encounter the cops, that they need to bow and scrape, if you think that people ought to lick the boots of the cops as they beat us down, then I suggest you just stay your ass inside on October 22nd and don't wear anything close to black on that day. But if you're somebody who hates this kind of injustice, if you're angry every time you hear of another police murder, if it saddens you to hear of mothers having to tell their children what they must do in order to have a chance to survive when they encounter some cops on the street, then you need to join us on October 22nd. The limits of what this system will do to people has a lot to do with what we will accept. We must make October 22nd a day when we deliver a message that we refuse to suffer this brutality in silence anymore, and a day to build up our strength to put an end to this madness once and for all. Join us. Stop police brutality, repression, and the criminalization of a generation. No more stolen lives. Wear black, fight back. The system is the problem, revolution is the solution.